What color were dinosaurs, and when did animals start being different colors at all? I'm Anthony Carboni, this is DNews, and color is a crazy useful tool for animal survival. Some are colored to blend in with their environments. Some venomous animals, like snakes, use bright colors for the opposite reasons, to specifically say, here I am, do not screw with me, which is called aposematism, which is Latin for, I think, badass. Colors can mean anything from, yo, I am ready to mate, to, hey man, I am a different species than you, please do not hurt me. But when did all of that start? Most animal coloring comes from melanosomes, which are these organelles inside of cells that make melanin that gives color and also protects from the sun. According to a study published in Nature, scientists have been able to recover some melanosomes from the fossils of dinosaur feathers, and they found similarities to living animals that allowed them to make some inferences, which is fancy talk for, man, I have no idea what millions of years of fossilization did to these melanosomes, but here are some thoughts. And those thoughts are, Anchiornis was black, white, and gray with a red crest on its head. Sinceropteryx seemed to be orange with a striped tail, and it looks like Archaeopteryx was all black. So how'd that red and orange get there? When did these animals start us on the road to the multicolored insanity that we have in nature today? Well, it seems like genetic mutation started color changes in a very small way. And then something happened in the late Jurassic period, specifically with a type of dinosaur called Maniraptors. All of a sudden, 140 something million years ago, all kinds of different melanosome shapes started appearing. All flying dinosaurs belong to the Maniraptor group. Researchers say that sometime right before the origin of flight, when dinosaur feathers changed from these tiny little fuzzy things to the feather shapes that we recognize now, there was this huge explosion in color variation. And that's leading researchers to believe that melanosome diversity is linked to big physical changes in an animal. Feather shape and metabolism changes to let a dinosaur fly, and its color changes along with it. Now that could mean color isn't just linked to an animal's environment or behavior, it could be linked to what it is physically made to do. And since melanosomes similar to dinosaurs can be found in living animals, we might be able to compare them and use them to find out new information about the physical makeup of dinosaurs. All this stuff is speculative right now, but it is crazy interesting to think about. Color linked to function, little color-coded animals like video game enemies. It's not like video game enemies, don't quote me as saying that. Hey, by the way, if you like what we are doing here on DNews, I've got another science channel where I do big experiments out in the world with my friend Tara. It's called Hard Science. It's at youtube.com/hardscienceshow, and if you haven't checked it out, please go do so, and subscribe here for more DNews.